Hello and welcome to the webinar. In this webinar, we will discuss how you can do easy theming within Magento e-commerce. So as we know, theming is one of the important concepts in e-commerce, and nowadays theming plays a crucial role to attract the audience within your web store, to keep the audience and easy to use user interface is always helpful to retain their trust, and so that they can see the same look and feel, they can easily browse through the website, can easily see the product catalog, can easily see the important controls like wish list, add to cart button in proper format. So to provide an excellent user experience to all the audience, to all the visitors, theming is an important element. So in this webinar, we will show you how can easily implement theming within a theme within Magento e-commerce. So this webinar will be presented by Shubroto, who is one of our senior Magento developer and is involved with many Magento projects where he specifically implemented several themes and regularly doing the changes within the theme. So he is an expert in the theming, the concept of theming within Magento e-commerce platform. So I'm just passing over the presentation mode to him so that he can continue with the content he is having to show to you today. And also he will be using a demo Magento store. So the steps which he is going to discuss, he will also show you through a demo Magento store so that you can also practice the same within your own Magento installation. And another thing is that this webinar is recorded. So once the session is complete, in 2-3 days, we will get the video link, the video uploaded to YouTube, and we will share the video link with you so that you can access the information anytime, as well as you can share the same information. We'd like to request you to list down all your questions, because I'm sure during the webinar, during seeing all these steps, you will have some questions. So we'd like to request to list down all your questions. There will be a 15 minutes question and answer session just after the presentation and the demo. So in the question and answer session, you can ask all the questions that you have regarding the concept of theming. So over to Shubroto now, who can start this session.
Thank you, Subhajit. Okay. So as we already told you that we are going to discuss about implementing a theme and simple steps to create a new theme in Magento. So first of all, we can see here the list which we are going to cover today in our webinar series. So installing a theme is the first on the list. So we will directly go to that, and I will show you how to install a theme manually in Magento. By manually, I mean you have to upload the themes files into your Magento store. So how we do that? Okay. So this is a demo Magento store which I have already installed. This is the admin section, and I'm using FileZilla as a file transfer protocol application for transferring all my files into my Magento stores, which is hosted on the server. Okay, so here, these are all the files of Magento. Okay, you can see here, just let me list it down. Okay, app, downloader, errors, includes, media, shell, screen, where. So during the discussion of theming in Magento, the folders which we are going to discuss about, or we will put special emphasis on, are app, media, JS, skin. But mostly, if you want to create a simple theme, these two folders, app and skin, are the two folders that we are going to put our emphasis on. Okay, so let's see how we can install a theme in Magento. So if you have downloaded a theme, and it will probably come in a zip format or compressed format. So you have to uncompress the file which comes with the download, okay? And after uncompressing that, if you go inside the folder which you created or which you uncompressed, you will find some folders like that: app, JS, media, skin. It may be possible that you have only app and skin, or only skin, something like that. Okay, so that depends on how the developer have created the theme. Okay, this package.xml is not important in our discussion, so we will just keep our focus on the these folders. Okay, so if you want to manually upload a theme into Magento Store, you just have to go into this folder where your theme files are, and you have to select all the folders and just upload it to the root folder where your Magento is installed. Okay, so you can see in our in webinar, my root, the root folder is my webinar, and here the Magento is installed. So I will just right click on it and select all the folders that I want to upload, and we'll click on upload. I have already uploaded the folders so that I can save some time. Okay, so after you upload all the folders and files, when you go to the front end, you will see in Magento by default, before 1.9, by default we have default theme already pre-installed. Okay, and if you go to the dashboard section, you can go to system configuration. And in the general section, you will find the design option. Okay, so current package name is default. Now, what is a package name? In theming, in Magento theming, we have two concepts. One is the package name and the theme name. So whenever we create any theme, we keep it under any package. Okay, so let's see what is the package. I will go to my FTP application and will show you where to find the package. So you have to open up app, design, front end. Theming is generally for the front end section where the customer visits the web store. So here we will keep our focus. It is also possible to apply theming on the admin section, that is the backend here. But we are not focusing on the backend section now. We will discuss only the frontend section, which is the place where you will sell your stuffs. Okay. So frontend, here you can see base, default, and RWG. Okay. So if you are using version 1.9 of Magento, this is the new RWG folder or package which comes along with it. Okay, so these three are the package we were talking about: base, default, and RWG. So there is an unwritten law in Magento that you never ever change file inside the base. Okay, so if you ever have to change anything, you can change inside default, that is fine, but never change anything in the base. Okay, so if you go to the backend configuration section again, we'll see here we have given the current package name is default, right? So in the backend, we'll see in under frontend, base, default, and RWD, that default is this one. This is the package we are talking about, and inside default, these are the themes. Okay, blank is a theme, default is another theme, iPhone, modern, and shoe store is the theme. This is the theme that I have uploaded. Okay, the custom theme. So now we have already given the package name. Just below it, you can see the theme section. Here are several options where you can set your theme. Okay, so translations, templates, skin, layout, default. So in the template section, this is the section where you give your theme name. Okay, so if you are using default package, and inside it you can see there are 5 themes: blank, default, iPhone, modern, Suite Store. Okay, but here nothing is given. So what happens in Magento is, if you give just the package name and keep all the other fields blank, it will automatically take all those as default. So we can see at the front end, this is the default theme of Magento, which is being shown. Now suppose we want to change the default theme. So what we should do? We have options of blank, default, iPhone, modern, and Suite Store. Let's check the modern one, which also comes pre-installed in Magento. So I will just go to the backend and will go to, give the template name as modern. Okay, I will save the configuration. We change it, go to the front end, refresh. Okay, so see, it's refreshing. We change it at the back end, but nothing changed at front end. Why is that? This is a very critical problem that most novice developers face. That is, you have to clear the cache of Magento. Magento cache is a thing which bugs many programmers, mostly the novice programmers who come to work with Magento. So first of all, whenever you are in a development mode, you can always disable all caches. How you can do that? Go to System, Cache Management. I'll open it up in a new tab and see all the caches are enabled. So what we will do is first select all those and refresh the cache. You can see enable, disable, or refresh. I will refresh the cache. And we'll also disable it so that it is easier for us to work. Okay. So in the backend, we have given the package name as default. The templates that we will be using is modern. And there are other sections like translation. What is translations? Translations are CSV files uploaded in the file system, which will translate English to any other language that you want to use. So if you are using a particular theme and you are translating it from English to Spanish, that means you have to keep a translate CSV file in your theme. And skin, layout, and default. Layout are building blocks which are used in Magento theming, and default is which default theme Magento will select or Magento will use if it does not find a file, particular template or layout in modern theme section, theme file system. So we will discuss this in later. Okay, so in the skin section, it is where our CSS images and JS files are located. Okay, so if you want to use modern template and skin of the modern theme, we'll paste it here and I'll save it. Save config. We'll go to front end and I will refresh it. Okay. So our theme change. This is the modern theme. Okay. So this is how you do settings in the backend. Let's see what we are going to do next. So in Magento mostly, themes controls the visual aspect of the site. What does this mean? That means the business logic that we apply in the front end or the process of giving order or adding products to cart, and the whole process is completely separate from the view that you want to show up. So if you are using want to use a theme and do not want to change any functionality of your site, you can do it easily in Magento. So I just shown you how to install a theme manually, that is uploading files in Magento file system and setting up file from Magento admin. So I just shown you how to do it from system configuration design. There is another section where you can change the design of your Magento store. Let's check it. So in the backend, this is the system configuration, and in the general section, design section, where we changed all these things. So if you have multiple stores in your Magento, you can see that listed here, main website, and there are two stores in this Magento, English and Spanish. So because we are applying the theme in the default config, all the store views will take it by default, because those are also selected as used as websites or used as default. This is called the configuration scope. So it is using website, which in turn is using the config settings, the default settings. So this is how it works. So the another section from which we can change the design is system design. Let's go there. Now it is important to remember, if you change anything from the system design, it will override the changing in system configuration design. Okay, so you can just click on add design change here. And you can select the store where you want to implement it. Suppose you want to change the Spanish store to something else. Okay, I select it and will choose the shoe store. Okay, the custom theme that we uploaded or installed, and I will just save it. Okay, now if I go to the front end and I will change the store from here. See, changed. Okay, this is Spanish store. So this is how you implement it from the backend. Now if you want to change the store theme, you just click on it and change it again to something else. Let's change it to default. Okay, save it. Go to home page. You can default fine. And if we change it to English, the English have modern theme implemented. So this is the modern theme. So there are two places from where you can change the design. One is system design, which will override the system configuration design settings. Remember that. Okay. So I just told you what is theme package and what is default theme. Now what is the default theme and how can we implement it? If we go to the system configuration again, system configuration design. So default is the package name, and the theme that we are using is modern, and the style CSS and JS and images that we are using is also from the modern theme. Okay, and this is the default template that we will be using. If we want to change the default theme that is implemented in Magento, now what is a default theme? So this default theme is In Magento, when you give a package name and a theme name, if you do not want to give any theme a particular name, you have to give it as default name. What is that? Let's go and check. So this is the default package. Inside it we have different theme names: the shoe store, modern, iPhone, blank, and default, right? So this default is implemented by default. Now what does that mean? It means if I do not give any default name of any theme here, by configuration settings or by default, Magento will assume that it is the default theme that will be used. How is that? Suppose you have made any changes in modern theme file system, and something in the header, and there are nothing else done in the body section or in the product page section. So by fallback hierarchy, Magento will search for the modern theme first, and then will go back and see if any theme name is given here. If it finds something, then it will use the files from that theme. Otherwise, it will just search for the default theme in that package that we are using. And if it does not find it in that, does not find any default theme in the package, then it will go to base default and will search for all the files. In base default, all the files are present, so it will just show whatever Magento has provided. Okay. So we will now show you how, what is a custom package or fallback hierarchy in Magento. So if you go to the file system, I will show you. In front end there are three package names: base, default, RWT. Okay. So default is our package, and we are using modern theme in the store at the front end, right? This is the modern theme that you are using. So what happened in the modern theme? There are layout files, configuration file, local templates, and in the templates are all the customizations that are done on top of the base theme that Magento have provided. So these are, if I go to the base theme now, let's go to the base theme and it will be better. Base default template. You can see in base default template, all the Magento theme files and folders are present. You can see that there are lots. But if you go to the modern theme, there are a few. Why is that? Because in modern theme, only these sections are changed and others are not changed. So what happens in fallback hierarchy is Magento comes here and searches for the file that it wants to show in the front end. And if it does not find it here in modern theme, then it will look for the default theme inside that package, the package name that we have given here. It will search inside that package the default theme. If the default theme is present, it's fine. If it is not present in the default theme, it will go to the base package, and inside that it will get the default and the files that are required to show. And if you have deleted anything from the Magento base system, then it will show you an error. That's why we always say that never touch the base. Okay, so that is how fallback hierarchy work. Now, what are the theme components? The main theme components we will be talking about is the layout, template, and skin. Now, what is a layout? In Magento, layout are just XML files. Layouts define the structure of Magento. Okay, and inside the layout are the template files, which shows what content will be present inside those blocks that the layout define. and the skin section contains all the CSS, JS and images that we want to use. Okay, so let's go to the file system and see what is layout and what is templates. So let's open up the modern theme that you are using, and this is the layout section. Okay, so you can see here catalog XML, catalog search, different XML files for different sections of Magento. Now if you want to see, you want to know how why is there is catalog, catalog search, checkout, something like that, this we have to go in much more details, which doesn't fall in this particular category. But there is an easy way to find out where, how to changes, make changes in these files. So I will just show you when I will create the custom theme. Okay, so this is the XML file which creates the building block. Suppose let's open up a XML file, page.xml. So you can see this is a XML file where the building blocks are present. So what happened, you can see there is a block named page.html, name is root, and the template name is given. What is that? That means this file is telling to use the page HTML block. When it's create a page HTML block, and inside the page HTML block, that is a certain page in Magento, there are different other blocks too. This is the head block. Similarly, there are sidebars if you want to use any. Let me page. This is the main content area. Reference name. So reference name is root. That means it will use the main, the whole section of the page. And if there is a sidebar, it will be shown as a left column or right column, something like that. Or root means the whole page. You can see two column left layouts, two column right layout, and this is how the building blocks are made. And whenever a block is created by these files, it always refers to the template which should be used in that block. So this is creating a page in Magento and is referring to the page two columns left .html. That means it is telling the Magento system to use two column left as the default layout. Okay, now if I go to the template, this is the layout section, and you have to go to the template file system template. You can see the path is given here is page two columns left.html. So what is that? Inside template you will find the page folder. You have to open it up, and it is saying as two columns left.html. So Magento will come and search for two columns left.html. So it will not get it here. You can see the two columns left.html is not here. So what happens? So the fallback hierarchy come into play, and it will go to default, and it will search for that in the template section, the page folder and two columns left. It is not here, so it will go to base, default, template, page, and we will find the two column left HTML here. So this will be the content that will be displayed in that block. So this is how layouts and templates are used. Layouts defines the structure, and templates defines the content inside it. And for similarly, the skin section. Let's go to the skin section. If I have to go a little back, in the root folder, you will find the skin here, skin folder here. In the skin, we have the CSS and JS and images files that for the theme that we are using. So inside skin you will find front end, go inside it, and base default RWD. These are the package names. So I will go inside default, and this is the modern theme that we are using. You can see CSS and images. So if you want to change any CSS files of modern theme, these are the files that are used here. Okay, so these are the main components which we use for creating a simple Magento theme. Okay. Now we will create a simple theme in Magento, and we'll see how it appears at the back end and how we can change files. So let's go back. Let's go to App, Design, Front End. So these are three packages: base, default, RWD. So if you want to create it in a new package, we can create it like this. Create directory, webinar. And our package is created. And inside this we have two options. Either we can create a new theme, that is the theme name that we will give will not be default, or just default. If we create it as default, then the fallback hierarchy will not search for any other folders inside this, and will directly go to base default, where it will search for all the files that it will not find it in the default folder of our custom theme package. Okay, so here you can create a new directory and name it the custom theme. Okay, custom. So this is how you create a new package and any custom name. Okay, similarly, if you want to create anything inside default, okay, you can select on default package and create a new theme, new directory. Let's name it custom theme. Okay. Custom theme. Similarly, we have to create another one in the skin section. So inside skin, front end, default, we have to create that theme that we have created here. Control. Custom theme. Inside it, it will put the CSS file, CSS directory inside which we can place these CSS files. Okay. Now if you go to the back end, we'll go to System, Design, and if you want to add a design change inside custom design, you can see the custom theme we have created in under default, and also the webinar package and the custom theme inside the webinar package are listed here. So just creating the folders in that particular format will show the listing of the themes here. So if we apply this theme, let's apply it and we'll see what happens. If I apply this theme in the Spanish store, what happens is okay, let's apply it here. I've already applied the custom theme here. Custom, save, we'll go back. Spanish and the custom theme. Save it. Go to the front end, and if I change this to English, Spanish, see, because we have no files and no CSS files, no template, no XML or layout files, this is how it shows, because this is showing the base default, that is the pure HTML files contents, no layout. That's why it's not showing any design, because we have not made any changes in the file system in the Magento inside our theme. Okay. Let's go back, change it to English. Now suppose in the back end we have given the default as modern, right? So it is showing as modern here in the front end, the modern theme. And by default it will, if it does not find anything in the modern section, then it will go to the default. Now we have seen here, we have created another theme called custom theme under the default package. So what we can do is, we'll apply the theme view. Okay. We'll remove the modern and we will apply our custom theme. Now remember, we have created nothing inside custom theme, it is blank. The CSS is blank, the template and block files is blank. So what happens is, what will happen, the Magento will look for all the files that it need to display on the front end and will look it in the custom theme. If it does not find it in the custom theme, it will go to default because we have kept it blank. Save the configuration. And fresh it. The default theme will show up. So you are, what we are seeing here is the fallback hierarchy. That is, if it doesn't find anything in the custom theme, it goes back to the default theme that it is looking for. Okay, now what happens if we give any name in the default section? Let's give it as modern. Okay, so now instead of looking anything in the default section, what Magento will do is first search anything in the custom theme. If it doesn't find, it will go to the default modern theme, because we have set modern as the default theme here. So let's save it. And see what happens. See, because it doesn't find anything in the custom theme, it falls back to the modern, which you have set as default. And this is the concept on which child themes are created. So this is very important. Okay. Now if you want to change anything in the themes, you just what you just have to do is copy the files and folders in the same pattern. Suppose we want to change anything in the modern head section. So I will go to modern template, page, HTML, header. I will just download the header file. Template page HTML, and will create the same thing in custom theme. Page. Inside page, you will upload the header. Okay. Header.html. Now at the front end, we can see this is the header section, which shows the Magento logo and page shaping, something like that. Let's change this one. Okay, so this is the header section which stores the home page logo and store language. Now what do we want to change, remove this logo? Okay, I will just for demo purpose, I will just comment this section and we'll see what happens. Because I'm commenting this entire thing, and we'll save and upload it. You see, it is uploaded in custom theme page. Upload it. And the front end, this section will vanish. Okay, one more thing. To save the use the header.html file, you have to also use the layout file. Let's go to layout page.xml. I will just download this one. Base default custom theme. Oops. You have to create the template. And the layout section. And in the layout, I will just upload page.xml. So, what Magento will do is find the page.xml, find the header, and we'll search for the template file mentioned in page.html in the template section here inside the custom theme page and that. Now if you refresh this one, it's not getting removed. So you can see we have made some changes, but still the section is showing. So how we can view from where this section is showing, or which template this is being shown? If we go to this system configuration developer, debug mode and change it to main website. You can see template path hints. We can just select it as yes and save configuration. And now we go to front end and refresh this. It will show us from where the templates are being loaded. You can see this header section is being loaded from default modern template page HTML header.php. So it is being loaded from the modern section. Now, so whenever you are making any changes in the file system and you can find that the changes are not being reflected in the front end, you can just open the template path hints and see that if your HTML files have really been implemented or not. Okay. So we can see our time is running out. So I will close this section and I will just open up the question answer front from your end. So if you have any questions, please.
Thank you, Shubhroto, for the session. I hope all the attendees enjoyed the session, and the session is quite informative for them, and they get a lot of basic idea regarding the concept of theming within Magento e-commerce. So I'm sure you all can see there is a pen in your GoToWebinar panel which is called question pen. So if you have any question, you can write it down there, and we will get those questions and we will answer those questions within next 10 minutes. So I'd like to request you to write down all your questions, all your doubts, related to this concept and related to theming in Magento e-commerce. So we have already received a few questions. So I would like to ask those questions one by one to Subroto to answer. So the first question, Subroto, is what is a child theme?
Okay, so child theme generally follows the fallback hierarchy. The similar one that I showed using the default section in the design one. So if you are using any custom theme and you are using the templates and CSS files of that theme, and if you want to change anything in the custom theme, so what we do is for themes that are purchased in Magento, we use that theme as the default one, the section that we have used in the default, like the name we have given as modern in the default option in the design section. So whenever a Magento system looks for the files, the template files or the layout files, it first goes to the template and layout section given in the design panel there, and if it does not find, then it goes to the theme section, the default theme section. So what happens is, whenever we are creating making any changes in a theme, what we do is create a new child theme in there and make the child theme and give the child theme's name on the template and layout section and skin section. Okay, and give the main theme's name in the default section. So what happens is, Magento first looks at the layout or the theme child theme's name and searches for the files and layouts there. If it does not find, it comes to the theme which name is given in the default section. So this is how child themes works. So the concept is not to change theme files and make your custom child theme and make the changes there, so that whenever you upgrade any theme, the changes that you have made does not go in vain.
The second question is one of the basic. What is the difference between a theme and a template?
Okay, templates are files in HTML files in Magento, which is the content that are put in the theme. Theme is the general terminology that is used for all the files and the CSS files, JS images, layouts, templates, everything which are used for making a theme. So template is a file, HTML file, which is used to create the content inside the blocks. The blocks are created by layout files. Inside those, the contents are created by the template files, which are the HTML files in Magento. And the design section is done by the CSS section, which is under skin.
Okay. Another question is, how many web pages people generally theme in Magento?
In Magento, whenever you are making any custom theme, you generally changes are generally made in the home page and the product pages, product category pages, the checkout page and the cart page, and also the CMS pages. There are no limits of how many CMS pages you want to use, so whatever number of CMS pages you want to use, you can create it. But in Magento, most common pages are the home page, cart page, catalog category page, product view page, product details page, that is, and the checkout page.
Is there any default theme available in Magento which can be easily programmed?
Yes, Magento comes with many default themes, as we were doing the default, the modern iPhone theme. And presently Magento is also giving a RWDD package inside which there is a default theme which is fully responsive. So if you want to create a responsive theme, you can use that as a base. So you can create a child theme inside RWDD and make changes.
Another question is theming process different in Magento Community and Enterprise Edition?
Theming is very similar in both Magento Enterprise and Community, unless you want to do some functional changes, because Magento Enterprise have some additional functionalities, that is some additional modules pre-installed in it. So generally there is no such difference if you are creating not a very complex theme.
I guess if you, we have you know, one two more minutes, so if you have any question, you can type it down in your, in the question pane, so we can answer those. So we'll be waiting for another 30 seconds if there are any question, and then we will end the session. Okay, thank you all for your time, and I hope soon we'll be organizing another session related to this topic of theming within Magento e-commerce, because as we know, in a single session this topic cannot be covered. There are many aspects and there are many options, controls, settings which are available. So obviously we will organize more sessions related to this session in a near future. Thank you all and have a nice day.